She's scared. I never put my hand on her, never did nothing like that, but she's scared what I potentially would do. She's afraid of what you've never introduced her to, like, a side of you that she doesn't understand. She thinks she gets you. And when a woman thinks she gets you, that's when it's all over. See, here's how it works for a woman. The amount of time that it takes for her to pussy you up is the amount of time that she sticks around to enjoy you being a pussy. So if it took you 5 years to pussy you up, she's going to stick around for 5 years to enjoy you being a pussy. And then she's going to leave you. You understand what I'm saying?
I see where you're going.
So you cannot, you can't just say, hey, bitch, don't work. Because, I mean, if the bitch is bringing home some fucking money, you can't be homeless and a pimp. So it's like, trust me, man, you can't be put in a position where that where you let, like, her having more money than you. Because women can't handle that shit. She's not going to be able to handle you having more, like, you having less money than her. She's not going to be able to handle you getting up in the morning, making her fucking breakfast. She can't deal with that. She's going to look at you like a punk. Do you understand? All a woman has in this world is that her man is cool. That's their presentation. If she presents you to the world as my stay-at-home husband, nigga, how can she do that? How can you let her do that? Present you, this is my husband, the wife. Do you understand?
Rusty, what kind of job does she want to get?
Well, she wants to work at some, I guess, some secretary at some office somewhere.
Not
I don't
even
know.
Something.
Okay.
If she's making six figures.
Do you make enough money for her not to do that?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay.
The point is not whether or not she's working, though.
Hold on a second. Hold on, Rusty. Hold on a second, Dante. From now, when you ask a question, you got to fucking have a point. Now, when you ask this motherfucker what his wife did and what he did, what was your point today?
My point is, if it was a job, like a career job, it's a secretary. It's like a,
right.
You know,
okay.
Whatever.
It don't even fucking matter.
Yeah, or if they need the money, that's significant. That matters.
Well, yeah, but you can't. See, that's the thing. You can't. Listen, Rusty, let me tell you something, man. You got to understand, for the sake of your fucking marriage, you hear me? For the sake of your marriage, do not get put in a position where she thinks you ain't cool. And I know that's some corny shit, but if she can't look at you like my man is the shit, then your marriage is over. Because you know that trickles down into your kids. They're going to start going, oh, Dad, you're a faggot. Ask mommy to do it. Do you understand?
Call you a faggot.
Yeah, I don't want that to happen.
Do you understand what I'm saying? Your kids and the people around you, they're all going to start to look at you with a little less of that lore that men have, man. Our walk, our talk, our arrogance. You know why bitches hate me, right? Hate is the same thing as love. If I wasn't arrogant, my girl said the other day, can you get off that pimp shit for once? I go, if I do, bitch, then what? Then what? What you going to do then? You need an opening to fag me up. Don't let her fag you up, Rusty.
Thanks, boys. I got a customer. I got to let you go. Thanks for your
time. Damn, fag. Hang up, you pussy. Rusty's a pussy.
I hate that work.
And look, and we're going to take a quick break real quick. We're going to come back with, like, all phone calls. So, Paulie, Bob, Scott, Jared, Mike, Oliver, and some bitches call, too, you scary assholes. You can call. I'll listen to you talk about nothing. All right, we'll be back in a second. Bye.
This is a man's world.
Yes, it is. Yeah.
This is a man's world.
I see your face, Kathleen. I see it.
It is.
But it's true.
But it would be nothing. Nothing.
We give you a little credit, though. Look.
Without a woman or a girl.
Give you a little credit. See, give you a small. Without a woman or a girl, either one, it doesn't really fucking matter.
You see?
Yeah, see?
Man made the car.
That's true.
Man made the car.
It wasn't a car. It wasn't Ellen Ford, bitch. It was
Henry.
Man made the train.
Uh-oh. Bitch didn't invent the steam engine. Bitch, no bitch is putting coal in the front of that shit. Did you?
Man made the electric light.
Electric light, Thomas Edison. Now that's the Godfather soul giving a white man credit for light.
Man made the boat for the water.
folks.
Like Noah made the ark.
Yeah.
This is a man.
We did everything.
Man.
Man. Right?
And it wouldn't mean nothing.
The name of the movie.
Not a woman on there.
Without some pussy. All right, thanks. That's basically what he said.
Exactly.
That's what he said. Basically what he said.
Gotta get some ass.
Wait a minute. Basically what he said is man did everything. And you know what? We need some pussy.
It's nothing without pussy.
Oh, this is a man. Man's world. Oh, hey, bitch, just suck my dick real quick so I could go invent a boat. He was getting his dick sucked. And he's like, oh.
You know what? We should get something to go in the water.
I need to
travel
be able,
in the water.
I need to be able to float on water. Mm. And then when he shot off, the sperm floated at the top. He said, ah. Like,
oh. I got it.
Oh, boy, we really, really are great motherfuckers.
Absolutely.
And you motherfuckers, y'all are on the attack. Y'all are on the attack to take away what makes us men. That's what you have to do, Kathleen.
I am not on the attack. I think you're just wonderful,
but
Patrice.
But your sister-in, or whatever you fucking call it.
My sister-in is wants to castrate you. Is that what you're saying?
You know they do. Tell the truth. Don't be scared. Tell the truth.
No.
What do you think the problem is with bitches right now? Like women from, like, say, 25 to 35. What's the biggest problem right now?
I really think that, like your thing with the Brazilian women,
mm-hmm.
I think that our society, there, it's not only puritanical in the you know, oppressed. There, those aren't the women you're going to meet. The ones that you're going to meet that are, it's just, I don't know. Our society.
Do you see that? Even a genius now. She's a genius.
Can't explain.
I'm not
they
a genius.
Don't fucking.
I got it.
I'll
explain
and
it.
And here's the great thing. Here's the great
There's
thing.
There's a lot of self-hating women in our society.
I think they're
and
just trying to test
Brazilian
you. A woman wants to be protected by her man, and if she can punk you up, how are you going to protect her against another man?
She's always looking to upgrade the protection. Is that
right.
Fair enough?
To upgrade the protection, no.
See, now, ladies out there, listen to me about how you think. Now, Kathleen, she has a low self-esteem, too, because we always call her a genius and stuff. She kind of goes, I'm not one. She has that little self-esteem thing, but this is the thing. Women never have a plan B with their thinking. That's their fucking problem. Like, she has an opinion, but the next thing that has to come out of her mouth is the reason for the opinion. Men, we pontificate and we're philosophical about anything. This is how men are. Men are like this. It's like we have these kind of conversations. Men can take any juvenile thing and turn it into some type of philosophical thing. Like we'll go, hey, would you fuck a bitch if she didn't have a knee, right? Or would you fuck a bitch if she was missing a nose? Now, I'm looking at fucking Than right now when I say that. And the first thing a guy will do is take his two fingers and put it over his bottom
think about
lip
it. Let me think
and
about
rub
that.
Them and go, you know, I don't
think I would fuck
I
a bitch
think
without
I would
a nose.
Fuck a bitch without a nose. Women, you don't embrace hypothetical thought, and you don't embrace, you don't ever need to expand on what you feel. That's why if a woman goes, I don't think, I would never sleep with, I would never have a threesome. And you go, why not? Girls just go, here's their answer. Because
disgusting.
It could be just bleh. You understand?
Yeah, okay. The thing is, I think.
All right, bitch. Get your 17 thoughts
okay,
together.
No.
Oh, shit. We have a girl calling? Oh. Go ahead, Krista. Krista?
Yeah. Yes.
Don't call. Wait a minute. Calm down now, sweetie. Don't call mad. You don't have to be mad to express how you feel. Just
no, I'm
calm
sorry,
it down.
I'm on a bus. It's just hard for me to hear. So if
oh,
I,
damn. You're on a bus. Okay. Go ahead, baby. Go ahead. I can
She's
hear you.
She's a loser.
Hold on.
Okay, good. I think that having a man stay home and be a stay-at-home dad is only equal. I mean, if a woman has been expected to do that for hundreds of years, then
yeah, and you should be expected to do it for
thousands of years.
Yeah. Why should this change? Are you motherfucking?
Well, why should? Okay, let me say this. There are a lot of traditions that are not necessarily good traditions. Okay, there is no reason that a woman. Why should a woman be oppressed and be forced to stay home as a stay-at-home mom if she doesn't want to.
It's not
if
a no. Wait a minute, Krista, hold on. I'm not saying
a career.
I'm not saying, sweetie.
Do that.
Sweetie, I'm not saying you should stay home. But I'm saying you should not make your husband stay home. See, I don't give a fuck what y'all do.
Well, you don't.
Wait a minute, Crystal. It's no, it's not equal. No, because here's what happens. You talk all the shit you talk, right? And I'm sure you have a boyfriend, right? You got a boyfriend?
Yeah, I have a boyfriend.
Okay, so the way you talking to a strange soldier means you talk to a motherfucker you familiar with even worse. But here's all the shit. All the shit you talking, right?